Hello, I'm going to show you today on how to capture data from multiple USB TC-08s using the Pico Log Recorder software. First step that you need to do is you need to plug in the devices to your computer and go through the Windows Found New Hardware wizard. This will get all the drivers installed for the devices. Next, what you'll need to do is go to your Start menu and actually start Pico Log Recorder. And it's going to bring up this Welcome to Pico Log window. You can do a guided tour if you want, which basically goes over all the functionality of the software, how to use everything, or you can do normal, which we're going to do normal in this instance. All right, now what we need to do is we actually need to initiate some new settings for both units. So in order to do that, we're going to go up to File and click on New Settings. Recording method here will be real-time continuous. On some of our other devices, you can do streaming or fast block, but for the TC-08, we'll want to use real-time continuous. Action at the end of the run basically tells the software what to do after it's done capturing for the period of time. So the default is stop. You can tell it to repeat immediately, so immediately start recording to a new file, or you can even tell it to repeat after a delay, so if you want to delay it for, say, 5 minutes. And in order to delay for 5 minutes, you would just simply put in a five here for 5 minutes. Since we're using multiple TC-08s, we'll need to put a checkbox next to this use multiple converters and then click on the OK button. Sampling interval is how fast you want it to record for each channel. So with the TC-08s, you can record up to 100 million or 100 milliseconds per channel. Here we're just going to keep it at 1 second. And then you can tell it to stop after so many samples or to stop after a certain time period. I'm just going to leave it at the default 500 samples. So go ahead and click the OK button. Now we need to actually add in the converters. So what we'll do is we're going to hit this Add button here. It's going to automatically search for the TC-08s. If you're using a different device, you can select your device that you're actually using from the drop-down list here. And we'll need to select the first unit that we want to configure. Click the OK button. Now we need to actually configure the channels that we're using on that device. So go ahead and double click on it. And the first thing you want to do down here, it says main frequencies. So it has built-in filtering for filtering out the harmonics on our AC power lines. So Europe, you'd be using 50 Hertz. Here in the United States, we're going to actually select that to 60 Hertz. And in order to set up the channels, we'll just double click on, say, channel 1. You can change the name here if you want to, and change the type of thermocouple you're using here. So I'm just going to click it, leave it this way it is, so click the OK button, and go through and set up all 8 channels on this particular device. So just going through, double check in, click the OK, double click, OK, and hit the OK button after you're done with that unit. Now we'll need to set up the second converter. So hit the Add button again and select the remaining serial number from the list, hit OK. And again, double click on that unit, change this to 60, and go through and set up the channels on this device. Okay. Click OK when you're done, and then click OK when you're done again. All right, now it'll have both units listed on the spreadsheet here with all 8 channels from each unit. It's currently in degrees Fahrenheit. If you want to change that, you can go to Preferences and Temperature and change the unit that you want to actually display it in. All right, now we need to actually tell the software where to save the data to. So in order to do that, we'll go to File, click on New Data, and choose a location that you want to actually save it in. So I just have it on my desktop in a USB TC-08 folder, and give it a name to whatever you want to name it. So Test 1. Click the Save button. All right, now we are ready to log. So we'll just hit this red record button right here. And the device is now logging for both units, all 16 channels. If we want to display the temperature readings while it's logging, we can click this graph button right here, and it will bring up a graph with all 16 channels displaying over the period of time that you're logging. If you want to clean this up a little bit, so right now we have 16 channels. It's a little crowded because of all the channels. So if I was, for example, logging one oven with unit 1 and logging oven 2 with unit 2, I might not want to see both units at the same time. So in order to kind of clean it up a little bit, I can hit this select channels button right here, and you'll see that they're all highlighted currently. So if I want to make two groups, oven 1, oven 2, I'm going to go ahead and deselect the second unit. So I have just the first 8 channels highlighted. I'm going to type in oven 1 and hit the save button. Now I need to set up oven 2, so I'm going to go through and deselect those units and select the second unit. 8 channels. And type in oven 2 and hit the save button. Now on this group drop down here, you can actually have oven 1 and it automatically highlights those units. So when you select it, it displays just those 8 channels. If I wanted to see oven 2, I can change it to oven 2 and it switches to just those channels. If you want to see a spreadsheet view of this live, we have a view spreadsheet icon right here. Just click on that and it brings up a spreadsheet. And let's expand this here so you can see everything. So it has all 8 channels, and then you'll notice it has both units here. So same thing as in the graph. If I hit the select channels, I can actually view just oven 1 if I wanted to. So now it's displaying just those 8 channels from that first unit. Now after everything's done and logged, we can hit the stop button, or you can wait for it to automatically stop after your chosen time frame. But we'll go ahead and hit the stop button here. And everything is now saved to wherever you put this PLW file. Now if I want to, say, open all 16 channels in Excel, for example, what I can do is I can go to File, Save As, and I can actually change this Save As type here to a CSV and save a CSV file to that location. So now if I bring up that Excel file, you'll see it'll have the time and then all the temperature readings from all 16 channels all displayed on your Excel file so that you can go through and make graphs and manipulate the data however you want to. And that is the basics on recording from two devices in PicoLog.